The firing of the artillery was like the mad rushing of bulls. And you could hear the bombardment as far away as Atlanta as they rumble in the background. Then the troops begin moving. Well, where we are right now, the Union soldiers will move across what is, you know, right here in front of us, and they'll move towards the mountain. The Confederate line is just behind you. Their outer positions are behind the what we have, the Georgia Monument now. And they're going to do a diversion here, what the Army calls a feint. They're going to try and fool the Confederates into thinking that this is their main goal, when really the main attack is going to be further south of here, at Pigeon Hill and Cheatham Hill. On your map, their tour stops 4 and 5. Now, the main battle is going to be at a place called Cheatham Hill. By the end of the day on June 27th, it didn't have that name. That's a modern name. They will call that line, the soldiers will call that the dead angle, because the line in the angle and the main attack that will take place there. And so as the bombardment's going off, the Union Army's waiting to charge. And the second that artillery stops, the soldiers begin moving. Well, the problem with that artillery bombardment, it wasn't as effective as was hoped. All it really did was warn the Confederates, when those guns stop, here comes the attack. So the Confederate Army's ready for them. And as the soldiers are literally filling the valley below Cheatham Hill as a human battering ram, the Confederates are waiting in their entrenchments. And one Confederate, he said, "It was only necessary to load and fire your musket to kill someone. You basically didn't even have to aim." And as those troops are coming up, they will find that the Confederates had hidden some of their cannons. They had camouflaged them, piled brush in front of them, and they waited till the Union soldiers were within 30 yards, and they began firing, tearing holes in the Union line. Many eyewitness accounts say it was like a blue wave crashed upon a shore, reformed, and crashed again. And there's enough Union troops that just sheer weight of numbers are going to carry them into the trenches. There will be hand-to-hand fighting in those trenches. And one Confederate, he said, "They threw rocks and beat them in the, we threw rocks and beat them in their faces with sticks, and the Yankees did the same." The life and death grapple of the two armies is going to take place in the trenches of the dead angle. If you get a chance, go down there, because that's one of those places that, you know, you definitely need to see while you're visiting here, because it is part of the park. And within about 45 minutes of fighting, the Union Army realizes we're not going to be able to break the line. But instead of retreating at Cheatham Hill, they're going to back off just a little bit, and they're going to dig their own line of entrenchments and wait for nightfall. And once night falls, they're going to start a tunnel. The idea is to dig a tunnel under the Confederate earthworks, fill it full of gunpowder, and on the 4th of July, set off a massive firework display, blow up a portion of the line, and break through. But that's going to become unnecessary, because on June 27th, the day of the battle, effectively the Union Army will lose the Battle of Kennesaw Mountain. They will attack with the goal of breaking through, and they do not. But one thing they were able to do is finally find a way around the end of the Confederate line, and they're going to start threatening that railroad again. And very quickly, General Johnston realized, uh-oh, there are actually Union troops closer to Atlanta than Confederate troops, and he begins to withdraw off of the Kennesaw Mountain line on July the 2nd, 1864. So we're going to go ahead and fire one more time to conclude the program. For those of you who just joined us, when you hear the gunner say ready, they're about to fire. You may want to cover your ears, hang on to the kids, hang on to the puppy dogs, and everybody stay in the roped off area, please. ask something of you. We're a national park. In national parks, we're in the business of being around forever. And the best way we can do that is if you, the public, really can appreciate these sites. So if you get a chance, learn more about the Battle of Kennesaw Mountain. Learn about the sacrifices that took place here. You know, you go in our museum and do that. We've got a movie. Because without the sacrifices of the soldiers here, I guarantee you, Kennesaw Mountain Park would be a subdivision. If you're one of my locals, you know that ain't a joke. So the more you learn about it, the better we can preserve this. So beyond that, if you've got any questions, I'll be up here at the rope to answer those. And thank you very much for coming out, and have a wonderful day here at Kennesaw Mountain National Battlefield Park.